As you develop an application, you need to account for values in your source data or application that are missing or empty. These values may appear to users as null and throw them off during their workflows. Null values could also trigger errors if developers do not account for them throughout their applications. For example, here's a summary view that should show an image of a vehicle, but users see this error when the app encounters a missing image. In this video, you'll learn how you can use two functions, abang defaultValue and abang isNullOrEmpty in your applications to handle similar null values. Let's first take a look at abang defaultValue. In this expression rule, I'll add abang defaultValue. When I click inside the function, I can see it has two parameters. The first is value. This is the value you want returned if there is not a null or empty value. The default parameter is for what you would like returned if the value parameter does have a null or empty value. In my test input pane, I have a single vehicle record. I can practice checking for nulls with this record. For value, I will add the vehicle's model field. I'll add the text string unknown if the model field has a null value. When I click test rule, the vehicle's model is returned. I will change the test input to a record that has a null value for the model field. When I test again, the default value is returned. This function is easy to use and is a good alternative to using the if and isNull functions together. Now let's see how I can apply this function in the Acme Auto app to handle null values when displaying a vehicle's record data. Here I have several text fields to display data from a vehicle's record. I added the abang default value to each field to account for potential null values. In the canvas, you can see that the year, make, and model return their respective values. The color field shows the dash, meaning the abang default value function found a null or empty value for this record's color. Now let's take a look at our next function, abang isNullOrEmpty. Imagine you're a developer at Acme Auto and you want to display the username of mechanics working on maintenance. But if the mechanic is missing, then this field displays as blank. This could be confusing for users. Is it blank on purpose? Is there an error and you just can't see the mechanic? I can use the abang isNullOrEmpty function to find null values and to create conditions. This function has one parameter, value. It will return true if the value is null, or false if it is not null. You can also use the abang isNotNullOrEmpty function, which will return the opposite. So how is this helpful? You can use these true or false outcomes to create a condition that tells Appian what you want to happen. Let's see how I can use abang isNullOrEmpty to implement a null check and provide a better user experience. I will create a rule that displays different values if a null value is present or not. I'll open the rule that formats this username. It starts with a match function that will look at a value, in this case, a mechanic's username. This rule then compares that username value to several conditions. These are the when true parameters. For the first when true parameter, I'll use abang isNullOrEmpty to check if the mechanic user value is null. If the mechanic value inside this abang isNullOrEmpty function is nullOrEmpty, then the output will return unassigned. Back in the interface, you can see these unassigned values. Now, when a user reviews these maintenance records, it is clear a mechanic has not been assigned. You learned how to use the abang default value and abang isNullOrEmpty functions to account for potential null values and ensure a smooth user experience. Developers should always ask themselves, how can I handle null values? This might be when filtering your source data, in your rules, process models, and beyond. Using Appian functions, you can create null checks to avoid a broken or unstable app, provide a consistent user experience for your users, reduce time spent chasing edge cases, or troubleshooting bugs. If you wish to learn more, check out the rest of this playlist to find videos on commonly used Appian functions. For more info on specific functions, visit Appian documentation. And to stay on top of our function series, please like this video, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to see more videos like this one. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.